What's up, you guys? I hope you're having a good one. In this video, you will learn about Next.js pages, routing, and navigation. After this video, you will know how to create new pages, how routing works in Next.js, and how to leverage the link component in Next.js to navigate between pages. All these things are basic features that are part of every Next.js application. If you haven't met before, my name is Tuomo. I'm a Finnish web developer with over 8 years of experience in the software industry. On this channel, I upload weekly videos and tutorials about modern web development. So make sure to hit the subscribe button below and let's get started with the video. Okay, so what are pages? Well, in Next.js, a page is a React component that is exported from JS, JSX, TS, or TSX file. And the file is inside the pages directory over here. And when a file is placed inside the pages folder, it is associated with a route based on its file name. And what this means is, for example, if we create a contact.jsx file inside this pages folder, it can be accessed from the /contact URL. And that works with folders too. So for example, if we create a docs folder inside the pages folder, and then inside the docs folder we create gettingstarted.jsx file, we can access that file from /docs/gettingstarted. So that's basically how routing works inside Next.js. So it's based on the pages folder and the file names of the files inside of it. Okay, so let's create a couple of pages and let's actually create these two pages. And the project I have here is just a fresh Next.js application that I created with Create Next app. So first let's add the contact page. So I'll create a new file inside the pages folder and name it contact.jsx. And then the getting started file. So let's first create a new folder and inside of that the file. And since a page was a React component exported from the file, let's add those components inside those files and export them. So let's start with the contact page. So I'll define a component and then we'll export it. Like this, I'll save it and then do the same with the getting started page. Like so. Now I have saved both of these files, so let's see if we can actually see them in our application. So I'll open up the console and run our development server with yarn dev, and then switch to the browser right here, and then let's try to open up the contact page. So it was /contact. And we get the text we defined, so the contact page is working. Then let's try the getting started page. So it was /docs/gettingstarted. And that seems to be working too. Great. So it's that easy to create new pages, and you also see how the routing works in this case. And I really like doing the routing this way based on the file names and the folder structure instead of maintaining the routes in a separate file, for example. So now we just typed in the page names to the address bar and accessed them that way. But next, let's see how we can actually add links to them inside the application. So I'll switch back to the Visual Studio Code and I'll open up the index.js page. And let's add a link for both of those pages under our heading. So I'll add a new div. And inside here, we will place the links. So normally we would do something like this. So we would use a tag in HTML to link between pages. But Next.js actually uses a link component from next link to wrap the a tag. So instead of doing it like this, in Next.js, we will use the link component like this. And then let's import it. like this. So instead of using just the A tag, we will actually place the A element inside the link component, and we give the href attribute for the link component instead of the A element. And why we do it like this is because the link component allows us to do client-side navigation between different pages inside the application. So basically, the link component doesn't refresh the page when navigating between pages, unlike when using the plain A element. So link component is used for client-side navigation between two pages in the same Next.js app. And if we want to link to another application or website, we will use the plain A element without the link component. So now that we have our contact page link, let's add the getting started link too. So I'll copy this and change the href and the text. Like this. And let's save this and switch to the browser, and I'll navigate to the front page. And now our links are right here. Let's actually add a line break between them. Like that. So now if we click the contact page, we will be taken to the contact page, and with the getting started link, we are navigated to the getting started page. And that's how you add pages and navigate between them in Next.js. Now that we know that, we can move to the next video, which you can watch over here.